What we have is Mondays, Tuesdays, and Wednesdays workouts up on the board, and we'll just run through them real quick, and then I'll chat about my thoughts about them. Monday, we've got two movements, 21, 18, 15, 12, of a 2 1/4 dead, 400 meter run. Tuesday, we're going to load up the barbell. We're going to work thrusters and some heavy pull-ups, varying weights. And the last workout's going to be just a pure strength overhead squat deal. So what we have, me looking at this, based upon the last 3 days cycle, which we had Holbrook, we had a chipper, and I think we had a bunch of sets of threes of cleans in there. I think over the course of that cycle, if you looked at how many different movements there were in the chipper and Holbrook, there was like three different movement patterns, and about 50% of them were gymnastics, like 5 out of 11. So it was kind of a heavy gymnastics cycle, kind of a cool thing to think about, because a lot of people blow off gymnastics elements. So looking at this, the first thing that kind of hit me was, compared to the last 3 days cycle, which was gymnastics heavy, we've got a lot more barbells, we've got a lot more load in here. We've got a weightlifting with a monostructural right there. This is all thrusters of varying weights and pull-ups, but some of these pull-ups are weighted, which make it a weightlifting movement. So we've got weightlifting, and then gymnastics at the end, so very heavy weightlifting as well. And the last day, just pure overhead squats, weightlifting again. 21, 18, 15, 12, beautiful, beautiful CrossFit programming, just a couplet, right? Just nothing too fancy, high power, a moderate, but yet it's still a heavy deadlift. You know, there's a slight trend in the community to go a little bit too heavy. People like heavy barbells, I do too, but it kind of kills your power output, makes you stand around. So keeping it at a respectable load is going to make you get through these deads a little bit quicker than you want, give you more legs for the run, and then right back to the barbell sooner than you think. And of course, this is just a huge midline stability, posterior chain, glutes and hamstrings are going to get lit up. You're going to be breathing heavy. You're going to get a cardiorespiratory response from this. And then you're going to sprint out the door at already a high heart rate with your glutes and hamstrings lit up, your hip flexors screaming at you. And you most certainly need a tight midline, a good upright position running, and you're going to be fatigued from the deads. So you're going to come in once again with the same muscle groups kind of blown up. Go back to the deads already, breathing God knows how hard, and go right back to using the same midline stability and posterior chain over and over again. So this is going to be a very, very demanding workout. Sometimes these rep schemes can kind of creep up on you. You know, it's not a 21-15-9, but it doesn't look that bad because, you know, it's descending, but there's 66 deadlifts hidden in there. You know, so most of us do a 21-15-9, you know, it's 45 reps, so this is over 30% more than what we're used to doing. So this is a very sneaky workout. Going to Tuesday here, day two. Posterior chain's been lit up, midline stability's been lit up, legs are screaming at you a little bit. Too bad. You know, there's a reason that Fran's so nasty, is because thrusters and pull-ups are a beautiful push-pull combination that just make animals and expose weaknesses. And so we're going to take those same beautiful movements and pair them together in a really cool way. Reps go from 15 to 21 to 36, so as the weight gets lighter, the reps go up. So somewhere in there is probably going to be where you felt the most comfortable, the most fatigued, and this will probably be a really telling workout as to where you need to tweak a little bit as an athlete. And also, what's really nice about this is the thruster. I mean, hidden in the thruster is just the beautiful building block of human movement, the air squat. So any form faults that you have, if your knees cave in, if you're not on your heels, you know, if your chest comes forward, it's going to be punished under these various loads. So good, just basic human movement mechanics in that squat are going to be critical to doing well in this workout. And we've got a beautiful push on the thruster and then a pull on the pull-up, so it's a beautiful push-pull workout, just like Fran. We're going below parallel, really didn't go below parallel on Monday with the deads, and we're going overhead. We didn't go overhead on Monday as well. So it's a good, you know, the key to a good GPP, general physical preparedness program, is variance. So we're hitting some good variance here. For time, I'm going to guess, I'm going to say 5 to 10 minutes is going to be where a decent amount of athletes are. So that's going to be miserable. And then Wednesday, Beautiful, right? Overhead squat, just in ones, not threes, not fives, you know. So in our, you know, what is fitness doctrine and things like that, we talk about the three metabolic pathways. And we've got that first one, there's that pure phosphocreatine pathway of just getting pure strong. That's all we're worrying about on a day like this. That's all we're concerned about. And this can be something that some people new to the program don't really realize with CrossFit, is they just think it's Helens and your Cindy's and your Fran's. They think CrossFit is this Metcon-y kind of a deal, which it is, but CrossFit's not just a conditioning program, it's a strength and conditioning program. And so this is one of our days, and we're just focusing on nothing but strength. Don't worry about the clock, take the time that you need between the sets, because every single one of these should be heavy. So if you're in that CrossFitter mindset of rushing back to the bar, you're going to lift nowhere near the amount of load you could if between each one of these repetitions you rested 3 minutes, 5 minutes, let your system recharge, and you go back on the back in there, you can really hit a heavy load again. And if the thruster was based upon good squat mechanics and was going to let you know if you had a couple chinks in your armor, things you need to work on, need to do a little squat therapy or what it was, the overhead squat, it's tough to think of another movement which is going to expose your faults and flaws better than the overhead squat. You need flexibility, you need coordination, accuracy, agility, and balance. Those neurological components are through the roof, and they're going to be as demanding as the load is large. So you're going to need a lot more of all those neurological components to overhead squat 100 pounds than you are 50 pounds. So if you're trying to stair step up on each one of these, there's going to be a dose hidden in there for sure. And you can attack this several ways, right? Do you know what your one rep max is? Maybe you can try to hold 80 or 85% for each one of these over the course of the workout. Or if you have a goal, maybe you want to hit that goal, maybe at like number five, kind of creep up to it, see how you're feeling that day. If you get it, maybe you've got a couple of lifts left of PR as well. If you miss it, you can stair step back down and still touch some heavy load. But each one of these should be heavy. Don't fall into that trap of, if you have a 200-pound overhead squat, don't count 135. That's still your warm-up set. Every single one of these should be heavy. So we've got a beautiful variety here, in great contrast to the last three-day cycle, like I said, that was heavy on the gymnastics elements, kind of heavy on the weightlifting here, and we'll see where we go on the next set. Good luck, everybody.